Good morning, everybody. Now we are studying the last chapter of 7th standard civics, that is lesson number 10, Struggles for Equality. When we started this civics, first chapter was on equality and the last chapter is Struggles for Equality. In the first chapter on equality, we have studied that the Indian Constitution states that we have all have right to equality. Right to equality means the Indian Constitution recognizes that all persons are equal in front of law, whether they belong to any caste, religion, sex, creed or place of birth, or whether they are rich or poor. So nobody should be discriminated on the basis of these criteria. So in the Constitution, since already it is mentioned, so all adults in India have the right to vote. So when we talk about right to equality, so right to equality means there is political equality, social equality, economic equality. So in political field, we can say that all are equal only when everybody has the right to stand for election and everybody has the right to vote. So anyway, Indian Constitution recognizes that everybody has equal right to vote during the elections, and this is called as the power over the ballot box. Now, ballot box is actually a box in which the people who used to vote in a paper. So this system was previously prevalent in India. Nowadays there is electronic voting machine. So as this ballot box is not used, but previously when people used to go for vote, a piece of paper was given to them. In that piece of paper, the names of the parties and the candidates and the symbols were mentioned, and the party to whom you want to give the vote, you can put a seal over in front of the name of that party or name of that person. Then they used to fold the sheet and used to keep it in the ballot box. So that is why it is called as the power over the ballot box. So when the votes were counted, so nobody will come to know that the paper folded and kept inside the ballot box was of a rich person or a poor person or anybody belonging to any sex, caste, religion. So nobody will come to know that who has given that vote or whose paper was that. So that means when counting is done, everybody's vote is counted equally. So that means politically there is equality in our country. So that is why it is called as power over the ballot box. So all adults in India have the right to vote during elections, and this power over the ballot box has been used by people to elect or replace their representatives. So since we have the power over the ballot box, everybody who is above 18 years of age can vote for the elections. So all those people have power over the ballot box. So they can choose their representatives, and next election, if they do not like, they can change their representatives. That again means that there is political equality, and this is guaranteed by the Constitution. Now, of course, equality over the ballot box is provided, but the feeling that there is equality in the ballot box does not extend to most people's life. But when we come to the social life or economic life, we see that this power of the ballot box is not extended to the social life. That means there is political equality, but there is no social equality. So again, ballot box, if we want to explain in one sentence power over the ballot box, then we can say that vote of one person is equal to other. So that is power over the ballot box. Now in the social field, we can see that there is no equality. So one field we can take of health. So health is one field or area in which we can see that there is great social inequality. It's because of the privatization of the health services. So we know that in our country there are government hospitals also, there are private hospitals also. So since more and more private hospitals are there and the government hospitals do not provide proper treatment. So more and more people are going to the private hospitals. So privatization of the hospitals and health service and the neglect of the government hospitals have made it more difficult for the poor people to get treatment. Like if we take the example of Kanta, about whom we have studied in the first chapter. So we have studied that Kanta was a domestic worker, and when she went for voting, so her Sahib was also standing in the same line where she was standing for voting, and both of them stood in the same line and voted. So that means there was political equality. Sahib was rich, Kanta was poor, even then all of them were standing in the same line. But when it comes to health facilities, so Kanta's daughter was ill, and when she took her to a government hospital, there was a long queue. She had to wait for a long time for getting treatment for her child. So then it came to her mind that does her Sahib also stand in such a long queue for the treatment? So of course not, because there is a private hospital, he can easily get the treatment if he paid more money. So Kanta at that time felt that political equality is there, but social equality is not there, because in health service she is suffering and the Sahib was in advantage. Similarly, if we take the example of Hakim Sheikh, about whom we have studied in the second chapter. So we have studied that Hakim Sheikh was a member of Pashchim Bengal Khet Mazdoor Samiti. That means he was an agricultural laborer, and once when he fell down from the train and he was taken to the government hospitals, he was denied treatment either because of lack of bed or lack of doctors, and he had to suffer with that injury for almost 14 hours, and at last he was admitted in a private hospital. So there Hakim Sheikh, because of his poor economic condition, he could not get proper treatment in the government hospital. So there he also lacked the basic health facility which he should get. So that also shows that there is no equality in health service present. Then if we take the example of Aman, so we have already studied the conversation between Aman and his friend. So both of them were studying in the same school, and his friend belonged to a rich family and Aman belonged to a poor family. And his friend got, both of them fell sick almost at the same time, but his friend got a treatment in a very good school, private hospital, and Aman had to go to government hospital where he was standing in a long queue, and then after the blood test report also came after 3 days. So though not much money was spent over his treatment, but he had to suffer a lot because of his illness. While his friend could get an easy treatment and with very normal and easy way he could treat himself. So these three examples shows that there is problem in the health facility provided in our country. Those who are economically backward or those who are poor are lagging the health facilities. So in this way we can prove that political equality is there, but in one field at